What will be printed in this program? Yes, 16, 1, 6, 16. So that means it is going to print the number of, it is going to print string length, right? We have a function strlen, right? Yes, no? Okay, see, whenever you call a function which is integer a is equal to strlen on sub pointer a, right? String length function. So this is how the string length function is implemented. Here we have a string which is getLectures.com. So it's going to store like this: G A T E L E C T U R E S dot C O M slash null. And you know the index locations are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and we have 16. Now if you pass this function xyz with p, so this a is pointing to this location. Now integer I is equal to 0, a of I plus plus, a of I plus plus. I plus plus means we are going to take the value of a of I, and then we are going to increment the value of I. So initially we are going to get the value which is g. So this is g, and g means true. G is not null, g is not zero. The sky value of g is not zero or null. So this is true, condition is true. And then the value of I will become 2. Again we'll go back here. Next time the value of I, this statement will become a. A is also true. So it will be true until we reach to this null character. So when we are going to reach to this null character, what will be the value of I? Value of I, 17. I mean, when the value of I was 16, then it will be null character. The condition will be failed, but the value of I will still be incremented. The statement is executed, value of I will still be incremented, right? So this will become 17. So it is going to return 17. But what is the length of the string? 16. The length of the string is 16. But it is returning 17. So what we can do? Instead of writing I plus plus here, you could have written A of I, comma, I plus plus. Like this. Now it is going to return 16 because the length of the entire string is 16. Correct? Okay. Got it? Sure? Pakka? Okay. Now check this out. Now this will be interesting. Main function. Integer I is equal to 5, comma j is equal to 6. If I is equal to j and I plus plus, then printf hi. If I is equal to j or I plus plus, then printf hello. If I less than j and j minus minus, then printf bye. and the second program is like this. This is the main function. We have integer I is equal to 0 and j is equal to 1 if I plus plus and j minus minus, then printf hi if I plus plus or j minus minus, then printf hello if I minus minus and j plus plus and j, then printf yellow. What will be printed in these cases?